Now let's move forward to the compound interest, and when we talk about compound interest, this is different from the simple interest in a sense na wala tayong linear expression like the simple interest. And in fact, we have this certain single payment compound amount factor raised to the period and multiply by the principal. So in short, itong compound interest na to, to be able to get the next interest, we're actually trying to use the present amount, and then we'll be using that to compute for the next interest. Now, to give you the exact definition, so we have this based on the remaining principal amount plus an accumulated interest charges up to the beginning of that period. So in short, if you're able to pay something from the first period that you should be paying, then yung natira dun sa principal amount mo, which is makukompute mo based on the principal amount and including all the interest rate subtracted by the one that you paid. So yun naman yung gagamitin natin ngayon for the next computation of the interest. And the formula boils down into this: F is equal to P times 1 plus I raised to N. And we call this 1 plus I raised to N the single payment compound amount factor. Now, we have two interest rates that we need to understand here. The first one is the nominal rate, and then the next one is the effective rate of interest. Now, in commercials, and especially in advertisements, you should always be getting this nominal rate of interest. And what is this nominal rate of interest? So, yung nominal rate of interest is your R. And this R basically means that it is the interest rate times the number of a period per interest period. Malino ba yun? So, ganito. Parang, if you have a 15% nominal interest rate and then it is compounded quarterly, so what you have to do is to divide this nominal rate of interest to that compounding periods. So that's 15 divided by 4. So basically, itong nominal rate of interest, it is the interest rate in 1 year. And, ayan, in 1 year. So, ganun lang siya. And of course, kung halimbawa, hindi siya 1 year, let's say quarter lang. So, basically, pag minultiply mo yung interest period dun sa certain number of interest rate per period, then you should be able to get this nominal rate of interest. And in short, the formula is simply this interest rate per interest period, which is equal to the nominal divided by the number of compounding periods per year. So, ito yung ating formula. So, just remember this formula. And then, how about the effective rate of interest? So, the effective rate of interest is the exact rate of interest on the principal for 1 year. So, alam naman natin na pag meron tayong certain interest rate na in-incorporate dun sa ating principal, alam natin na hindi talaga yun yung parang nominal rate interest na we have. For example, this nominal rate of 15%, alam natin na if it is compounded quarterly, we know quite well na this should be the interest rate per interest period is 0.15 divided by 4, which translate to this portion here, 0.15 divided by 4, and that is the interest rate per interest period. But knowing that this occurs in 1 year, so therefore the actual effective rate of interest would be converted in that number of interest period within 1 year. That's why this one is raised to 4. So and the formula in finding our effective rate of interest is simply 1 plus I raised to M minus 1. So what you have to do here is to find the interest rate per period, then raise that to the compounding years, and then subtract 1, and then you'll be able to get the effective rate of interest. So, yun, ganun yung computation natin for effective rate of interest. Now, itong future and present worth, so actually, is na-discuss na natin to before, or nabigay ko na siya ng idea, no? So, instead of just using the simple interest, so we'll be using this compound amount factor, and this is usually represented in terms of this now. So if you have F, so to be able to get this future worth, what you have to do is to multiply the principal with your compounding factor, which is in this case you can read this as F given P at a certain interest period, and then within this period N. So that's it for your future worth. Now, for example, if you have, we need to find the future worth of a principal that is 2500. So what you have to do here is to multiply this by 1 plus 0.06 cubed, because if you're given, so this one is your given, the I mean you're given with the principal. So what you have to do here is to multiply that, so dun sa factor niya, which is 1 plus 0.06, and then this one is positive 3. Kasi what you have to do here is to find your F, and diba ang F should be increasing. How about your present worth? So if you're given by the future worth, which is 2500, and then you need to find your principal, so this should be negative 3 because that becomes your denominator. So alam naman natin na if you have F is equal to P times 1 plus I raised to N, therefore kung gusto mong hanapin yung P, diba, this should be F times 1 plus I raised to negative N, and this is what happened here in that example. We can just simply rewrite this 1 plus I raised N in terms of something like P given F at any I percent interest, and then at any year, which is this compound amount factor. Now let's para pa ba tayo dito? Okay, so ito yung cash flow diagram ng ating present and future worth. So if you have a present worth, then yung inyong future worth would be this cash flow diagram. So yun lang naman yun, usually ano yan, represented in terms of two arrows lang and then this certain period. Now the rate of interest is related to the discount rate, which can be solved by taking your discount rate and dividing that rate by 1 minus D. So, you should be able to get your discount rate. And the other way around, pwede naman compute natin yung rate of discount given your interest rate. So, just use your shift solve or just rearrange this equation. So, basta pag discount, sinabi natin is future worth minus present worth. So, iba ito dun sa sinasabi natin na ano na discount sa presyo, kasi diba alam naman natin na about 50% discount, so you just subtract 50%. Now basically this just means na kaya siya discounted is that we're trying to subtract the future worth to the present worth, kasi alam naman natin na yung isang let's say we have a certain product, and then in the future it will increase its worth probably. So basically what we're trying to incorporate in the discount is that we're trying to sell that product in the present so that it is kind of discounted dito sa future, I mean sa present. Now this discount is actually your interest paid in advance, kaya meron kang future worth minus present worth lang yung gagawin natin dito. So yun for discount. We'll be solving for that then later on. And I think siguro isama ko na din tong diretso natin hanggang continuous compounding, and then continuous compounding and discrete payments. So sabi dito, in discrete compounding, the interest is compounded at the end of each finite length period, such as the month, quarter, or a year. So pag continuous compounding naman, it is assumed that the cash payments occur once per year, but the compounding is continuous throughout the year. So the equation for discrete compounding in the lender's viewpoint is this one. So if you have a nominal rate of interest, and then this M is the number of interest period, so yung R over M is the interest rate per period, and then yung MN mo is the number of interest periods in N years. So mas magagaya siya once na we solve something like this na yung ating discrete compounding. Now, when we talk about this continuous compounding natin, if we have M over R is equal to K, which means na yung ating M is magiging R times K. So, if you try to substitute that to our equation, makikita natin, makukuha natin itong gantong form, okay, from this. Kasi magka-cancel out yung ating R. And then, if you try to take the limit of this expression, okay, raised to Rn, and then if you take the limit as your k approaches to infinity, kasi this is the number of times you're trying to compound. Kasi, diba, we're in continuous compounding, we're trying to compound it continuously throughout the year. So, we're trying to find the limit as this compounding approaches to infinity or at a very large number. So, diba, alam naman natin na this expression, 1 plus 1 over k raised to k, if you try to substitute infinity to this, 1 plus 1 over infinity raised to infinity, diba, this expression is exactly equal to the Euler's number e. So with this, we can rewrite that expression in terms of the Euler's constant E. That's why your formula becomes F is equal to P e raised to R n. This is yung madali natin tandaan, yung Pern. F is equal to Pern. Yun yung parang usually laging ano eh, laging sinasabi ng mga nag-aaral ng econ. So, yun yung Pern. Basta tatandaan nyo lang yung mauuna yung F lagi kapag positive yung inyong mga values ito. Kasi basically ating future worth is usually, diba, sila is mas mataas sa inyong P. So basically that makes sense when you have a value of your periods or number of periods in terms of a positive unit. So basically yun lang yun for our continuous compounding and discrete for our compound interest. So in short, itong mga continuous compounding compound interest is that kung ano yung natitirang principal mo for every payment that you do. So yun yung gagamitin naman natin for the next computation of your interest. That's why it is compound interest. So paliit siya ng paliit, pero it's not linear, pero if ever you're not able to pay such amount, so the interest will accumulate and then mas malaki yung mababayaran mo if you're not able to pay for that. So yun muna, and then let's try solving problems regarding this topic. So I think that will be number 5 to let me just check. Okay, so I think let's solve for number 5. Now let's have this first problem. A man wishes his son to receive 200,000 10 years from now. What amount should he invest if it will earn interest at what amount should he invest if it will earn interest of 10% compounded annually during the first 5 years and 12% compounded quarterly during the next 5 years? So to be able to solve this, I'll be making a cash flow diagram. Okay, so oops, so kailangan maganda rin yung cash flow diagram nyo para mag-gets nyo ng maayos, kasi kung gulo-gulo din edi walang sense, no? Okay, so ito yung ating cash flow diagram, no? And then ito is 0, so ito yung beginning of the period. Now, since this is compounded annually, let's just make the interval na 1 year ang gap. So, I have 1, okay, then 2, 3, 4, until I have 5 of them. I mean, 10 of them. So, kulang pala yung ano ko, ginawa ko. So, extend natin. 8, parang ano eh, parang pataas. Anyway, so yan. So, meron akong 10 years. Now, kung gusto nung man na makareceive yung anak niya ng 200,000 10 years from now. So, basically, kung tayo ay ano, nasa man's viewpoint. Ganun, man's viewpoint. No? Okay. So, basically, makareceive yung son niya. So, basically, kung siya yun, makaka-receive siya ng 200,000 dito sa ating by the end of 10 years, no? So, 200,000. So, remember, ang ating cash inflow would be positive, kaya pataas siya, no? And then, any outflow would be negative, so downward. And then, ano ba yung kanyang kailangang i-invest? So, that is at the 0th year, no? So, yun yung kauna-una ang year niya. Magkano kaya yung kailangan niyang i-invest para makakuha siya ng gantong amount? So, basically, ito yung kanyang i-invest na amount. And, supposedly, dapat mas ano to, mas maliit pa siya dun sa 200,000 natin. So, ganyan. So, what should be your P? P siya kasi this is your principal. Parang kung ano ba yung initial amount natin na kailangan i-invest. Now, we have to specify things out here, no? Kasi we need to understand na for the first 5 years, so starting from your very first investment up to this point, sa 5 years, 10% siya, diba? 10% siya, and then this is compounded annually. So, for the next 5 years, so you have here 5 years, and then going to the 10th year, so you have 12% compounded quarterly. So with this, if you compound this quarterly, so you can just say that n is equal to 4, kasi quarterly mo siya gagawin eh, diba? So this one is n is equal to 1. Okay. Now we should understand that this is compounded for the first 5 years. It is compounded annually. So basically yung m natin dito is 1, but for the first for the next 5 years we are compounding this at a certain interest rate of 12% compounded quarterly. So this becomes m is equal to 4. Okay. So this kind of compound interest, this one is a discrete discrete compound interest. So we can solve now for p. Now what we have to do here is to make this future worth equal to the present worth. So ang gagawin natin ngayon dito is we'll try to make this or bring this to our present time. Okay, so ayun, ganun lang gagawin natin. We have to make this at your present time and then equate natin yung dalawa so that we will be able to get your p. But how do we do that in this case? So alam naman natin na if this is the future worth and then this one is the present worth, we have something like mayroon pa tayong stop muna dito, no, sa 50. Kasi hindi kasi natin pwedeng idiretso siya doon kasi alam naman natin na this point here is iba yung interest rate nito dito. So stop muna tayo and then saka natin siya idiretso. So if I'll be labeling this as your p prime, okay, siguro ibahin natin yung kulay. So if I have something like p prime here, okay, so ito yung atin muna magiging initial na principal from 10 years going to the 5 years here. So with this, we can say that the equation for your p-prime, which is your principal, dito lang, dun sa ating 5 years. So that means that if you have this future worth, that is 200,000, and then you multiply this with your p given f, okay? So this is the factor that we'll be looking for, so that is at i percent and then n. Okay, so we have p-prime that is equal to your future worth, that is 200,000, okay, and then we multiply this by p given f i percent n. So in this way, I have 1 plus, and then this one is r over m, and we know very well na itong 12% would be 0.12, and then we divide this by the number in the number of compounding period, so that is 4 kasi quarterly siya kinocompound, and then we have 4, of course, times the number of years, which is 5 years. So that is 4 times 5. Okay. So ang formula na ginamit ko is yung, kung matatandaan nyo, we have this something like P is equal to F, then 1 plus, baliktad rin natin. No? So we have F is equal to P times 1 plus, and then we have R over M dito, and then M times N. So this is your expression for the future worth given your p. But in this case, since we need to find p given your f, so this becomes negative. That's why we have to incorporate the negative sign here. So sana nag-guess niyo yung portion but siya naging negative, no? It's just that we need to find the present worth given your future worth. Now this is equal to 110,735.1508. So hopefully store niyo na yan sa inyong calculator para hindi kayo magre-write pa ng mga values as well as mas nakakadali yun kasi exact value talaga yung ini-store ninyo, no. And then how about this p? So again, yung p prime natin ibibring natin to sa ating pinaka present, which makes this another equation which gives us your p is equal to your p prime. So ang mangyayari, itong p prime, considering this portion lang para magiging siya na yung future natin, like this one. So p given f, and then that is i percent, and then n. Okay, so with this, your p becomes this value, 110,735.1508, and then multiplying this to your compounded annually, diba? So 1 plus, so 0.10, that is 10% compounded annually. So wala ka ng divisor dito na 4 kasi you have compounded this annually. But you have to raise this to your 5 years. So that's negative 5 as well. So your final answer should be this value. So hopefully, ang maging sagot dyan is mas mababa pa rin sa 110 kasi pabalik tayo eh. Now remember, what happens is that if you have a future worth and then we're trying to bring this to the present, then you have to expect that your answer is become or becomes lesser. Pero syempre, pag we have p and then we have to move forward to the time value, then it should increase. By the way, the answer is equal to 68,757.8164. Okay, so this is our final answer for this problem. So you have, in short, you have to invest, or the man should invest 68,757.8164 for his son to be able to receive 200,000 by the end of the 10 years. No, assuming that, of course, the interest rate for the first 5 years is 10%, and then the interest rate for the next 5 years would be 12% compounded quarterly. Okay, so this is for the problem number 5. So let's move forward naman to our next problem. Okay, for the next problem, we have, by the conditions of a will, the sum of 25,000 is left to a girl to be held in trust by her guardian until it amounts to 45,000. When will the girl receive the money if the fund is invested at 8% compounded quarterly? Now, for this problem, we should be able to understand this by drawing cash flow again. So, yun na yung gawin natin laging ano, method pag medyo nako-complicated, so we do cash flow. Pero pwede rin namang hindi pag medyo ano na kayo, expert na kayo sa solving for this kind of problem. So this is zero, no? And then we start by having this 25,000. So basically, kung may iniwan sa'yo na 25,000, so meron kang pera, no? But of course, para lumago yung pera na yon, you have to trust it to your guardian, and then para makuha mo siya by then into a larger amount of money. So basically, nagkaroon ka ng pera, but you have to invest that. So basically, ang mangyayari, going ano, down na tayo yung ating araw, kasi even though you have your money, you have to invest that. So basically, mawawala na siya sa'yo, no? Sa simula. So that is your principal, that is 25,000. Okay. Now, this is compounded 8%. I mean, this is 8% compounded quarterly. Let's have this 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the number of periods that you have. And then let's have this. Lagyan ko ng ganun. That means na there is a certain time interval in between here. Okay. And then finally, at your maturity rate, parang ganon. So you should have this 45,000. So this is. This should be your F that is equal to 45,000. And then this one, this ano, is 8% compounded quarterly. Okay? So I hope kompleto na ating given. And then what we have to do here is to just solve for the value of our N. Kasi N yung ating hahanapin dito. Kasi when will the girl receive? So if we have this formula P or F is equal to P times 1 plus we have this R, nominal rate of interest, divided by the number of compounding periods, and then the year times your M. So the number of the years that you're trying to pay for this. So your F would be 45,000. That is equal to 25,000. Okay? And then 1 plus your nominal rate of interest is this one, 8%. So pag sinabi sa inyo usually na 8% compounded quarterly, 10% compounded yearly. So yun is basically your nominal rate of interest. And di ba we need I here, which is typically this value. So anyway, we have 0.08. We divide this by the number of compounding periods. So that is 4 kasi quarterly siya eh. Pag semi-annually, we have 2. For ano ba, every 2 years, so we have 12 for that. I mean, we have 6. So for this, we have your M, that is 4, and then yung N is actually our unknown. So you can just use your shift solve function and then find the value of N. So for this, the value of N is equal to 7.4206. So you can use years here kasi based on quarterly type, so for that it's translated to yearly naman. So basically, the girl will be able to receive this certain amount after 7.42 years. Now, kung halimbawa nagkamali kayo ng solution, for example, nauna nyo tong 25,000 kasi you're trying to use this as future worth, no? Wala namang problema kung magiging ganito yung solution nyo, but make sure na yung inyong exponent to your compounding factor would be negative in this case. So, same lang din sila ng magiging sagot. So, dapat ganun lang din. Pero this is how we solve for such kind of problems where we have this certain interest rate and a compounding period, and then we need to find the certain amount of time that we'll be able to get that certain principal na ininvest natin. Okay? So much for this. Hopefully, ay nag-guess siya. Mas simple to compared sa naunang problem eh. Now, I think this is the last problem for compounded interest kasi the rest would be something like amortization. So, the payments will be done in accordance to a certain value of A for that certain problem. Kaya, hanggang dito na lang muna tayo for compound interest. Now, let me read the problem first. At a certain interest rate compounded semi-annually, 5,000 will amount to 20,000 after 10 years. What is the amount of the end? I mean, what is the amount at the end of 15 years? So, medyo ano yan, medyo tricky yung tanong na yan. Actually, we don't have the idea about the interest rate dito kasi kung mapansin nyo, we're just given by the money here. So, gagawin natin ngayon, gawa ulit tayo ng cash flow. Okay? And then we'll try to figure it out from this, no? So, ito is a zero. And basically, yung nag-invest ka ng 5,000. So, lagyan natin dito 5,000. Okay, so we have 5,000 here. And then, after 10 years, so we have 1, 2, di ba compounded semi-annually ito? So, basically, kung this is compounded semi-annually, we can use 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 for this one para maging ano lang niya. I mean, 6 months, ganon. Pero, let me just use per year na lang dito kasi hindi naman siya sobrang ano importante yung interval for this case naman kasi interest lang kinukumpute natin eh. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. Hopefully tama yung bilang ko no. So this will be 20,000. So parang 4 times siya na no. 20,000 na siya by the end of 10 years. So this is 10 years. Okay? So hopefully malinaw yun. And then what is the amount of the end of, what is the amount at the end of 15 years? So mag-add ka pa ng 2 3 4 5 years here, and then what would be this final future amount that we have? Okay, so to in this problem, let me just write this as F prime kasi hindi siya yung final future worth natin. And though you can use any letter or any representation, whichever suits you well. Sa akin is F prime na lang. Kahit ano, pwede yun. Basta make sure na yun is, ano, naka-specify sa problem. Okay, so, this is 5 years, no? And then, what is our interest rate? Now, for problems like this, no? Yung interest rate na tinatanong dito is not the nominal, but your interest rate per interest period. So, pwede rin naman siya na annual interest rate. Pero, for cases like this, we're trying to find the interest rate per interest period mo na, no? And then after knowing this interest rate or interest period, we'll be able to get your value of future worth after actually 15 years. So with that being said, ang una natin gagawin is that we need to find I from this given 5,000 to 20,000. So madali lang naman siyang gawin. We know quite well na yung ating 20,000, which is the future worth, this is given, this is equal to 5,000. So hindi ko na susulat yung formula, pero sige, susulat ko na, baka makakalimutan nyo eh. So 1 plus we have I raised to negative n lang naman dyan, diba? So if it is compounded or discrete, kasi this one is a discrete discrete compounded interest, so we have r over m instead dito sa ating ano to. So we have n times n. Okay, so actually, it should be positive pala kasi I'm using ano dito, future worth. So, positive yun. Okay? So, we have 20,000 is equal to 5,000, and then 1 plus the nominal rate of interest would be R. Okay? That is R over M. You can use R over M or simply I here. So, if you're trying to use the nominal rate of interest, mangyayari lang dyan is di-divide pa rin natin siya sa M. So, you can just use I dito Okay? Para maging r over m. Pero make sure na we're doing this, multiplying this by 2 kasi semi-annually siya, and then your n would be the 10-year period. So that is your formula. And then from this, your I, which is the interest rate per interest period, would be equal to, so that is 0.07177, or this is around 7.1773%. Okay. So, ito yung, i-store ko siya para mas tama yung gamit natin. No? Now, this interest rate per interest period is not your nominal interest. And if you're asked what is the nominal rate of interest, you just have to multiply this by 2 kasi we're dealing with the semi-annual compounded interest rate here. So, basta pag nominal, multiply natin sa 2, yun na yung ating nominal rate of interest. But in this case, kinompute ko na yung per period kasi I lang din naman yung gagamitin ko for this. Okay? So, if we need to find F, okay? So, if we have F here, we start with this value, and this would be our present worth in this case. So, that is 20,000. Okay? And then, this will be your present worth in this case, F prime to, diba? F prime. And then, we multiply this with the interest rate na nakuha natin. So, 1 plus 0.07177. So, the question is, do you still have to divide this by 2? Again, hindi na. Kasi this is exactly the interest rate per interest period. Had this been nominal rate of interest, then you have to divide this by 2. And basically, if the nominal rate of interest is around 0.14, then you should divide it by 2 to get 0.07177. Which, in this case, is no longer necessary. So, we proceed with the computation, so that is 2, and then ilan taon na lang ba? So, 5 years na lang, so that is times 5. So, therefore, your, the 20,000 that was extended, parang ganon, that was given some extension to mature, will become 40,000 in this case. So, medyo malaki-laki pa yon, no? Kasi imagine kung halimbawa meron kayong for 10 years yung 5,000 naging 20,000 na, no? So, imagine kung meron ka pang 5 years maging 40,000 na yung value na yun. And kung halimbawa, kung mapansin nyo, diba itong 5,000 naging 20,000, so basically 4 times 4 yung ano, no? yung kanyang multiplier. So parang for 10 years meron kang 4 na times 4 yung ano, yung maging future niya. Pero kung mapapansin nyo, di ba meron ka lang additional na parang 15 years. So, kapag 15 years, parang naging times 8 na yung ano niya, yung pera niya. Kasi ano eh, kasi for 5,000 naging 40,000. So, kung mapapansin nyo, hindi siya parang ano, hindi siya nagko-correlate dun sa idea na. So, if 10 years to and then 20,000 to, so basically for times 4 yon. So, in-expect ko na if that is the case, then this should be something like 6, diba? Kasi 4 to, so this should be parang times 6, which in this case should be 30,000. But in this case it's 40,000, and that's the reason why we call this the compound interest rate, because kung ano yung na-accumulate mo dun sa certain point of time before compounding, then yun yung gagamitin mo for principal para ma-compute yung next amount ng nagiging pera mo. So basically, this is a better option for those who want to invest, especially kung compounded interest rate yung ano yung in-offer sa inyo, no. Pero kung halimbawa hindi siya compounded, let's say yung annual nominal, I mean ordinary simple interest rate lang, so you don't have to expect a lot from that, and then hindi siya magma-mature into a very large amount kung ganun lang yung ating magiging mga interest rate. So hopefully ay na-get nyo itong compounding interest rate. Meron lang tayong dalawang formula na sinusunod, or actually isa lang talaga to, general formula lang. It's just that kapag discrete siya, meaning specify yung number of amounts of, I mean yung number of compounding interest as well as yung years na yon. So you use this r over m raised to n m. Pero kung interest rate lang, annual lang, pero compounding, then you just use this n. So wala kayong multiplier na years. Pero either way, parang same lang din naman yung concept niya. It's just that you're converting this in terms of discrete payment. So, with that being said, I have to go back to the module and discuss things about annuities.